Recently, we've added some new performance improvements to Azure SQL Managed Instance, and there's only good news related to these. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Vladimir, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi, Anna. It's a pleasure and a privilege to be here. Glad to be with you and your audience.
We're happy to have you. And today, we're going to be talking about some new performance enhancements that are coming to Azure SQL Managed Instance. So I really just want to toss it over to you, Vladimir, and understand, you know, what did we announce and can you share any details related to it?
My pleasure. So I have a couple of slides that I've prepared. Let's switch to the slides. Essentially, Azure SQL Managed Instance has been around for a couple of years, but in this recent period, we've shipped a number of performance improvements that together compound to a huge boost in Azure SQL MI performance. We've significantly improved the transaction log write throughput for both general purpose and business critical instances. Then we've also improved the data and log IOPS for business critical. We've improved the performance predictability for general purpose instances. And then we've also done work to improve the tempdb performance. And all of these taken together essentially create a major breakthrough, a major boost to the performance of Azure SQL MI. Now, in terms of more details, here's what this means. So the log weights or the transaction log write throughput for SQL MI general purpose instances has been significantly improved. The previous limit in place was 22 megs per second for the whole instance. Now the per instance maximum is at 120 megs per second, so more than 5x improvement. There's the additional caveat of that you cannot realize the full 120 megs per second with just one database because there's a per database limit depending on the size of the log file, and then there's details in the table below, but essentially you need a 2 terabyte log file in order to get to the full maximum of 65 megs per second for a database. And this is a major, major improvement. So more than 3x per DB and 5x for the whole instance. For the business critical instances, the limit went up from 48 megs per second to 96 megs per second for log rates. But we've also managed to improve the IOPS, the IO operations per second, from 2.5K to 4K, so 60% net improvement in the IOPS category as well. How this looks is like this. So again, major improvements coming to both general purpose and business critical. Now, what this means to your workload is, depends on the workload for sure, but we've done extensive testing here with the engineering team, and we've seen improvements anywhere from up to 2x to more than 4x in transactional throughput for different kinds of workloads. The most, again, most workloads benefiting more 2x or more. So this is all I had in terms of the slides.
Awesome. Thanks, Vladimir. I mean, this seems like some significant improvements as far as performance goes. You know, I got to ask, like, there's got to be some sort of pricing implication that, you know, customers now need to be aware of. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I have some fabulous news to share because all these fantastic improvements are made available with no additional cost. Essentially, we've upgraded the horsepower of the SQL MI engine for no extra charge to the customers. So this is absolutely no, there are no pricing implications for this improvements at all.
Wow, that's awesome news. We're getting like huge improvements with no cost.
I love my car manufacturer to do the same kind of upgrade for me as well, if it were possible, right?
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, what are some things that customers like can now do because of some of these performance improvements?
Well, essentially, to leverage the same analogy, given that you know, SQL MI has more horsepower, more muscle, there's an opportunity now to migrate more performance-demanding, performance-hungry workloads to Azure. So, essentially, SQL MI will be able to take on larger and more complex workloads compared to what used to be the case only a month or so ago.
Awesome. Cool. Now, you know, I'm assuming that this applies for obviously any new Azure SQL Managed Instances, but if I have a current managed instance, do I need to migrate? Like, do I need to turn this thing on? Like, how do I start taking advantage, take advantage of these improvements?
Well, I have more good news. We've made these improvements automatically available for all existing and new managed instances starting sometime mid-September. So essentially, by the time your viewers get to see this, their instances will very likely already be upgraded to the new and improved performance limits.
Awesome. So what I'm hearing is starting in, you know, mid-September, I'm not going to have to pay anything extra. I'm not going to have to change anything, but I'm just going to start running faster, which is awesome news.
You're going to wake up one day and your instance just became faster for no extra cost. Exactly.
That's awesome. I'm
if
sure
it sounds like magic.
yeah, just like magic. This is going to make a lot of our customers and viewers like very excited. So, you know, Vladimir, thanks so much for coming on the show and sharing this information with us. We're going to put some links in the description to learn more if you want to see exactly what's being improved. And we really hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.
Thanks, Anna, for having me. Nice to be here, and I hope to see you again in the near future.
Awesome. Bye-bye. Thanks.